Tributes continue to pour in following the death of nominated Senator Victor Prengei, who passed away at the Nakuru War Memorial Hospital following a road accident along the Nakuru-Kabarak Road on Monday night. His remains are currently at the Umash Funeral Home in the county, from where Ruth Sarumwei joins us live. Ruth, how are people reacting to the death of the senator?
Well, residents from Nakuru County, as well as the family in Nakuru County, are still coming to terms with the death of Victor Prengei, which occurred after a road accident. So here at the Umash Funeral Home, we are joined with some of the family members and some of the leaders who've come to condone with the family and pass their messages of condolences following his sudden death. So we are here joined with Daniel Kubei, who will speak on behalf of the family. So Daniel Kubei, we are really sorry for your loss. So you can just tell us as a family how you received the death of
Like any other Kenyan or any other person, we were really sad, and we had no words as a family to express, because it is something unbelievable. Most of the people were calling and asking, what is happening? And I keep on asking, I'm told he's no more. Those were the words. We received, most of us received calls from 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. at night, that he was in a War Memorial Hospital, and only to arrive to be told that he has passed on. Mm-hmm. So it is a sad moment for us as a family, and for the Ogiya community, and for the marginalized communities.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We are also meant to understand he was championing for the rights of the Ogiya community, just as Daniel Kubei has mentioned. And we are here with a representative who's speaking on behalf of the minority groups. So I understand that there was a bill that he had passed to the parliament and was presented to the Senate. You can tell us more about that.
First and foremost, pass my condolences to the family, Ogiya, and minorities and marginalized communities in Kenya. We have lost a leader. He was the only political leader that we had as minority community, being the only nominated senator. And we are shocked. As senator, as we have been working together, I'm the head of minorities and marginalized communities in Kenya. And 79 communities, we have been having hope that through him, we have a bill that went through parliament, Article 100 on special interest groups. Now it is in Senate. Mm-hmm. We have been working with him closely for that bill to be passed, so that minorities and marginalized communities in Kenya, mm-hmm, will get representation. So it is very sad at the moment, because the timing of this death is really, mm-hmm, it is a shock. It's heavy on our side. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Senator, I don't know how you are remembering. You can have your mask on.
Okay.
Yeah. How do you remember the fallen leader?
Actually, we are all quite devastated this morning, or rather since yesterday, when we got the news of the accident and then shortly thereafter the passing on of our friend and colleague Senator Victor Prengei. As you can see here, we have his family. He was a youthful, cheerful, great, really humble senator and human being, so to say. And I worked very closely with him being a member of my delegation, mm-hmm, from Nakuru County in the Senate. Mm-hmm. And I can say he really passionately pushed for the interests of the minority communities. Mm-hmm. So it's a great loss. More so was above that to the family, the Ogiya community, Nakuru County, and Kenya at large. So it's really a terrible, sad day. But it is well, mm-hmm, and we are hopeful that we shall be able to get through this. Thank you.
So other leaders have continued to pour out their tributes, including Deputy President William Ruto, Wiper leader Kalonzo Musyoka, among other leaders who continue to remember Victor Prengei as a leader who was humble and served the rights of his people. So we are going to follow up on this story, and we'll keep you updated. Back to you, Victor.